case of the six. So, we missed. But I'm back. So here we are! This is mega...
Oh my gosh, that went... I just breathed it into my lungs.
You just breathed what into your lungs?
The water. I was trying to drink some water and I inhaled rather than swallowed. Anyway. Megadeth victory! For the big homie, Jade Spirited. Jay has a line of shirts. I'm going to put the link in the description of this video. So if you're interested in checking out his shirts, that's where you want to go. Actually, we should have worn one of them for the...
I know.
But we switched the song actually, last night.
I was rocking one of Jay's shirts a couple nights ago. I like the material.
Yep.
I like the color. So shout out to the big homie, Jay.
Right.
Jay Dispirited! For time and topical political commentary, you can hit us up in Middle America with Vin and Sori. If you, dear listener, would like a song reviews, very, very simple, $125 at the gate. If you do that three times, then it goes down to the original $75 price. If you were doing the $75 price before and you did it three times and you get grandfathered in, all that good jazz, okay? This is victory from the band Megadeth. If you want to be part of our Facebook community, facebook.com/VinAndSori.
Links are in the description.
Let's go. Oh, website's coming up pretty soon here. Very excited about that.
Mm-hmm. Good stuff. Good stuff
good
everywhere.
Good stuff everywhere for everyone involved.
Ready?
Go!
Place you can go without a mask. Go.
No one dares on telling everyone that killing is my business. And I was hung like a lady. From looking down across my school beneath the street. Bars aside, the last fight. Life got death by friends. And my eyes started seeing battles in my head. Couldn't run up like Friday.
Go!
one.
I really like this one. Whoever Megadeth in a while, so...
Yeah.
I forgot what a crazy guitarist the big homie is. So,
I'm just going to pull up the lyrics here, because you like to do this rapid scroll up and scroll down thing while you talk, and I want to see the lyrics myself.
No, they're right there. So it looks like this is all...
We were looking at the lyrics over here, so people are like, why don't they look at, the camera or the whatever? We were looking at the lyrics.
People don't know that? I mean, we're...
No, I don't know why people... Like, usually our lyrics are over here, but they're in a different place. Because there's a bitch.
There's a jihad happening. Fuck you very much. Fuck all of you.
So, we have to stop cursing, because a lot of people are watching when their kids are with them. They're watching our show.
Oh! Hey, little Timmy.
Don't say those words.
Don't say those words!
Vinna mad.
No, I'm not even mad. Vinna free, actually.
Shout out. Okay. First of all, at first, so when he was singing it, I'm like, okay, something's not going well. I mean, he's being hung like a martyr. Like, I thought people were kind of coming after him. Then I got thrown off because he said, but some crazy shit's has happened since The Conjuring. So I thought, oh my gosh, like, he was involved in some seance and they conjured up some things and now weird things are happening in his life. Because he said, I started seeing bad omens in my head. Will I wake up dead? All those things. But then, when he said, had fingers in my eyes, had needles in my veins, and then I thought, okay, actually, I think we're probably talking about drugs here. And it's weird because it sounded to me like it wasn't going well, like the drugs were kind of taking over him. But then he said, I am victory. So, and it kind of had like that. I am a victory. So, oh, I changed that to I am victory, Matt. So then I thought it was.
You change it in the title?
Him overcoming. No, the whole thing, it's just victory.
Okay.
So then I thought it was about him overcoming his thing with drugs. I just don't understand what had fingers in my eyes means.
Honey, these are all.
What?
Song titles.
Had fingers in my eyes, isn't
it? Killing is my business. Last rites.
I mean, I recognize
Good morning, Good morning, Black Friday. I'm pretty sure we did that one. He talked about
in the hey, you have your own.
He talked about P-cells. So these are all songs.
Oh yeah, I know. I noticed it down here.
I'm pretty sure The Conjuring,
Holy Wars, Tornado.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure The Conjuring is a.
Hangar 18. I recognize all those.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure The Conjuring is a song too. So I think. What this is actually is him looking back at how far he's come and saying, I'm still here. I didn't OD on drugs, like, I'm still here. Because this was 94 and they started in the 80s, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. He got bounced out of Metallica.
Yeah.
Da 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 da. And so all these songs that it's like he's going through his,
his catalog.
And saying, hey, I'm still here. I didn't die. I didn't OD like a normal rock star. Yada, yada, yada. I'm here. Because a lot of the stuff that he wrote about was, really heavy stuff. Mm-hmm. And, a lot of these guys, in hip-hop, it's a little bit different. You know, when people say... you write about stuff and it doesn't mean that you necessarily went through it. Mm-hmm. You get a lot of like gangster rappers who were never really gangsters. Mm-hmm. But they're reflecting what they see in the community, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they themselves went through it. Whereas with metal, aside from the fantasy stuff or whatever, when these guys sing about problems, it's problems that they themselves went through, like 99% of the time. Like, the proximity between the art and the experience, in my opinion, is much closer in metal than it is in hip hop. Mm-hmm. Because hip hop, you have some guys that it's like DMX, I'd say, is a guy that it's about coming from experience and expression. But a lot of hip hop is about, at least the hip hop I grew up listening to. I mean, honestly, I've lost touch with hip hop now. Mm-hmm. I've lost touch with rap because
Well, we do.
This. We've been doing this for the last 2 years, and you know.
And then on your spare time, it's the songs that you love from.
The songs that I like, right? Mm-hmm. So, but hip hop seems to me more. And I'm not. I mean, hip hop is my home base. Like I'm Bronx, New York. I mean, that's we invented rap. Like, so I'm not. You know, saying that hip hop is trash or whatever. I'm just saying that. Experientially, metalheads, as far as the artist goes, there's a much more closer proximity to, hey, I experience this and I'm writing about it, whereas hip-hop is more like, mm-hmm. this is what people want to hear, or this is a persona that I'm trying to put out to people. I want to act like I'm a tough guy, I want to think I'm a gangster, yada yada yada. The girls, it's always stereotypical, they're going to talk about sex, yada yada yada, you know, whereas, you know. So anyway... So I think he's looking at the catalog of his song list and he's saying, you know, I went through a lot of stuff. You know, The Conjuring, you know, Killing Is My Business. Mm-hmm. I think that was a song he was criticizing probably the military-industrial complex. And then, of course, people went crazy on him because how dare you? How dare you criticize America, you know? So he's saying whether it's political issues like that or spiritual issues like The Conjuring, you know, or, you know... suicidal issues or whatever, thinking you're gonna wake up dead, yada yada yada. I still made it. I'm not even close to overdose, and so that's where the victory aspect comes in. Like,
yeah, that makes sense.
And I think it's you know, there's a big balance between, you know, tooting your own horn or whatever, and looking back and celebrating,
yeah,
the fact that you overcame a lot of bullshit.
Yeah, I think that. And I think that people can kind of see the difference, you know, between, you know, I'm going to be the first to congratulate myself, and, like, I overcame some hard stuff.
Right.
You know?
Right. Well, so you're talking about LeBron.
Yeah, I am.
LeBron, he hit some record a couple of years ago. It's like 2 years ago. Actually, we shot a video on it. You remember that?
Yeah, we did. That's right. It's on the channel somewhere.
LeBron... Yeah, you know, he beat some record. He passed Michael Jordan's scoring or something like that. And of course, Jordan only played 13 years. LeBron's on his like 17th, 18th year. So, he passed Jordan in scoring, and so he wrote this Instagram post, and he basically said, "Let me be the first to congratulate you." I've never seen anything like that before. That was a little bit over the top.
Well, I think, too, that the other thing is, when people can see that you went through some difficult things, and that you survived those difficult things, like, there's a difference between the celebration of survival and the, just, I'm greater than you all feel. You know what I mean? Like, it kind of has, there's a different feel.
Yeah.
A different feel to it, you know? Like, he was, not that, you know, obviously, if any of us felt that we were better than Michael Jordan, that would probably be like a pretty big win. But I think that, you know what I mean? Like, his bar is, I'm better than one of the greats. One of the greats you all celebrate. Or there's like, you know, like, I could have overdosed and I didn't, and I came through all of that. Like, they both have a different feel to them.
Yeah. This is more like, I overcame problems.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Whereas LeBron was like,
I overcame all of you's great.
Right. Which... You know, I
don't necessarily have a complete issue with that, because I think that people, you know, it's good to be happy about, but I don't know. But LeBron.
Yeah.
And to come across, so.
Yeah.
And I don't see a whole lot of his stuff, just, you know, anyway.
Yeah.
People are like, why are we talking about
this? Well, no, I think it's a very, very tight balance of tooting your own horn and celebrating the fact that you made it out of a bad situation and not only survived, but you thrived. Like,
yeah.
You know, so, yeah, I get it. But I think everybody likes stuff like this.
Mm-hmm.
The LeBron stuff, people don't like. But, you know, he...
But this I don't stuff, know if that's because of jealousy, because in stuff like this, like, we all have, like, obviously if he would have fell to the overdose, that would have been considered, you know, like, a fail or, like, a negative thing in his life.
Right.
You know, so because he overcame something negative and he found himself victorious, like, all of us have negative things in our life that we have to fight to overcome. And so I think that that's very relatable. And I don't think that everybody is in the same, like, I think that some people walk around so defeated all the time that they don't get to overcome a great, you know what I mean? They're so busy just overcoming the negatives that they never get the opportunity to overcome a great. And so I think that there's a bit of jealousy that can be in that.
That's a very, very good point. Very, very good point. And, you know, I'm a LeBron fan, and I'm not one of the, I don't believe in false humility. I think one of the most arrogant things people can do is act humble. You know, because then it creates a situation where people go, no, you're better than that. You know, I would much rather have an accurate view of my, like this channel. I believe this channel is the most dynamic channel on YouTube. Because we have so many different things that we can do, and both of us are talented in different areas. And you know, there's a lot of things that happened behind this. Like, for example, we were on the drive, we were talking about how, you know, our villagers have stepped up and you know, on that GoFundMe situation. And we've been able to, you know, so we've been able to do a lot of stuff. Now, obviously, as Christians, we believe that it's all God and God's plans and all that, and for sure. But you know, I'm not gonna say, oh, we're a whack channel. Go watch other, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I also say, if somebody were to say, okay, what is the best reaction channel on YouTube? I'd say Lost in Vegas. I feel like those guys are the standard whatever. But if just on the reaction channel alone, sure. But you know, I feel like we do different things. You know, we're you know, and we do them well. You know what I mean? So I just think having a real sober understanding of who you are and not trying to play the humility card and acting like you're less than you are so that people can say, no, you're much better. Well, at the same time, like, not being silly. It's like, you know, LeBron, you know, can't you let other... I mean, there's been a debate for years about LeBron versus Jordan. Like, why do you have to go out there and say... You know what I mean? Like it doesn't make sense to me. Like, let other people do that. You got people that are going to ride for you. You know, LeBron was in that barbershop. There was this episode because he's got this barbershop thing where you just have a camera in a barbershop.
He has wine, right?
Sometimes. And he was talking about, he said, I surpassed Jordan in the finals against the Golden State Warriors. It's like, that's so weird. Like, come on, bro. Like, let other people say that. You know, let another let another praise you. But this is really good, though, because I often get people asking me, why does God let us go through all this hardship, yada, yada, yada. And, you know, this is one of the answers, is that he wouldn't be singing this song with so much passion.
Oh, absolutely.
If that suffering did not create a certain type of drive and desire in him to continue and to overcome it. And so, you know, God's always doing 10,000 things in any one given situation, but this is one of them, which is to kind of, it kind of gets you some emotional sort of strength, you know, like, all of us have to go through, in my mind, my philosophy, all of us are allotted a certain degree of suffering. And it's God's intentions for that suffering are always, always good. But you do not see them in the immediate. You see them later.
That's what I was thinking.
And so,
overview.
Yeah. So if you think about all the collective suffering that went into all these song titles. to
that
produce,
must have been a good feeling to put all your song titles into a song.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know, maybe lots of bands do it, but this is unique to me. I've never seen this.
I've never seen something like this before. And the funny thing is, it's like, I don't think I've ever really... Because Dave Mustaine is known as the guitar god. He's he's a guitar legend. And so he doesn't really get a lot of credit, as in my mind anyway, as a lyricist. But this was very, very smart lyric writing. Very smart concepts, too. That's the other thing about writing lyrics, is that what's the concept? I think that's another thing that's a little bit different between metal and hip-hop. Metal, many times, is more thematic and conceptual, whereas hip-hop is more, you know, direct and it's not necessarily... Like, you don't see a lot of hip-hop concept albums. like, I can't really think of a concept record from hip-hop, whereas metal has dozens and dozens and dozens of them.
I'm surprised that there's not one about, like, somebody's life.
Like, well, Biggie had, you know, Ready to Die, but it wasn't a concept record, you know, and so... The thing about Biggie, though, is that he would write songs that were stories, you know, like, so that all three verses are about one story, which, thematically speaking, is one of the things in my mind that separates Biggie from pretty much everybody, is that his ability to do that, to write a story with the lyrics and have it be engaging, and, you know, that's where the whole, you know, that Akhenaten song was kind of in that vein of, you know, telling a story, which that song is coming out soon, dear listener. If you want it, we'll probably release it on Patreon. But it's, it's very, very interesting.
But can you tell me what "had fingers in my eyes" is supposed to mean? Because
I think "fingers in my eyes" is one of his songs, right? I don't know. Let me.
Oh,
yeah,
is it?
Yeah. Like, I'm gonna Google Megadeth "fingers in my eyes." Let's see. Is that a song or a lyric or what? Yeah, I don't know. "Fingers in my eyes," I have no idea. But "needles in my veins" is obviously about drugs. So maybe people do that when they are on drugs. They put fingers in their eyes.
Oh.
Maybe they do that. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
Who knows? But either way, none of that stuff overcame him. And it's, you know, he had throat cancer or something like that last year.
Wow.
And I think he's okay, though. I think he beat it. So he got diagnosed in June. But I think he made it out of it. So, there you go. Good on him. What do you give the song?
It's a 9.9 for me.
I really like that solo, man.
I really enjoyed that solo. Being about victory, you know?
Yeah, I really enjoyed that solo. I really liked it. I haven't heard one of those, like... That's one of those, like, 80s Iron Maiden type solos that you're on the elliptical, trying to break trying to break 9 minutes in 2 miles. Beautiful stuff. I'm going to go with a 9.5. Very, very good song. Very good song. Shout out to the big homie, Dave Mustaine. Who is this for? This was for Jay?
Yeah.
Shout out to the big homie, Jay DeSpirito.
Buy his shirts.
Love you, buddy. buy his shirts. You're going to put that in the...
Yep.
Okay, buy his shirts. We have merch too, but get his first. Then Al.
Sorry, Al.
Gone! Now what?